Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Sarachandra IAS Academy. Today, as part of our discussion and analysis on economic survey, we are going to discuss the ninth chapter. Ninth chapter is Jai Ho. The chapter name itself is Jai Ho. This talks about the analysis on Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana scheme and also the health outcomes we achieved because of the introduction of this scheme. PM Jan Arogya Yojana, Ayushman Bharat PM Jan Arogya Yojana scheme and its positive effects on health outcomes in India since its inception of the scheme. You know, this is again, this survey again giving more importance and trust to healthcare and health insurance. Already in this same economic survey, we already discussed in the fifth chapter, healthcare finally takes center stage, Already we had a thorough analysis on healthcare, and in this we are going to discuss health insurance, provision of health insurance as a public good for the more vulnerable sections and its impacts, health outcome impacts on the in the states in which the scheme has been implemented, and also we compare the health outcomes in states where the scheme has not been implemented so far. So friends, you know, the provision of public goods is prerequisite for meeting the social welfare requirements of the majority of the vulnerable sections and poor people. The provision of public goods and public services is undermined generally in market economies. So in market economies, the rich people can get this provision of health services because of the fortunes they have. They can go to the private services. For example, if you take the healthcare, whenever we talk about healthcare and healthcare provision in India, the first thing that strikes to our mind is private sector. The public healthcare services in public sector has been not up to the mark, and the quality has been very poor. That is why most of the people spending a lot of money as out of pocket expenditure on healthcare services. So to meet the health as a public good, especially the more poor people and vulnerable sections, health insurance scheme has been introduced in 2018 in government of India in the name of Ayushman Bharat PM Jan Arogya Yojana. Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. This scheme has been introduced in 2008 to meet the health insurance of the precious public service provision. So it was introduced in 2018. Before introduction, there were other health insurance schemes were implemented in all states. For example, we have already PM Swasth Bhima Yojana, and also some states which have capacity, they had been implementing their own schemes, their own health insurance schemes, which states which have the capacity to implement. For example, Andhra Pradesh, Arogyasri is a health insurance scheme that had been implemented even before introduction of this Ayushman Bharat scheme. So anyway, this Ayushman Bharat scheme, since its inception in 2018, it targets to benefit almost 50 crore individuals, who belong to the vulnerable and bottom section of the society. And these 50 crore people are, it also covers almost 10 crore 74 lakhs families, 10 crore 74 lakhs families, and almost, which is equal to the 40% of total Indian population. This scheme covers almost 40% of Indian population. So this scheme is being implemented in the ratio of 60 to 40, so money allocation from the center and state governments. Central government will give the 60% of the money, and state governments have to allocate almost 40% of the money to implement this scheme. And the total health insurance provided for each family is 5 lakh rupees. Is 5 lakh rupees per year. It is this, the beneficiaries have been selected based on the occupational based on the occupational deprivation, based on the deprivation and occupational criteria from the data got from the socioeconomic survey 2011 socioeconomic survey, the beneficiaries have been selected based on deprivation and occupational criteria. So the scheme entirely takes care of the secondary and tertiary care in government hospitals and some of the empaneled private hospitals. The scheme is about providing tertiary and secondary and tertiary care in most of the government hospitals and some of the empaneled private hospitals. The scheme also covers the expenses, pre-hospitalization expenses for 3 days and post-hospitalization expenses for 15 days. So it is a scheme which has been implemented to reduce the burden on poor people, especially poor people and below poverty line people who can be trapped into the vicious cycle of debt, vicious cycle of debt because of out of pocket expenditure. Many study streams of reports says that out of pocket expenditure in India is more than 65%. This scheme aimed at to reduce the burden on that. Now let's take the what is the progress of this scheme since its inception in 2018. So according to the data released by National Health Authority has been set up to take care of the implementation of Ayushman Bharat Prime Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Since its inception, the National Health Authority released its data in 2019. So according to this data, this scheme has been implemented in 32 states and UTs, and so far 13 crore 48 lakh e-cards have been issued to the beneficiaries based on the SECC criteria, and almost 7490 crores have been almost spent on this scheme. Almost 7490 crores have been disbursed to implement this scheme, and this scheme benefited almost 1.55 crore hospital admissions on point. Since its inception, there were almost 1 crore 55 lakhs hospital admissions in 24,215 hospitals. In this period, almost 1.55 crore people have got admitted, and it benefited 1.5 crore households so far the inception of this scheme. Apart from this data, we also have the data that this scheme has been extended to 23 specialties in and 1573 hospital procedures. 23 specialties and 1573 hospital procedures and healthcare services, the scheme has been extended. This is the statistics so far we have. Based on these statistics, we also conclude that there are certain positive outcomes. There are certain positive health outcomes we can observe since the inception of the scheme. What are these positive outcomes? That the scheme has been stretched and extended to providing low cost healthcare services and high frequency and low cost cares consisting of the general medicine. Most of the services provided in the general medicine which are low cost and high frequency and low cost healthcare services have been provided in this period. And this is about specialty. Most of the low cost and high frequency hospital beneficiaries included in this low cost and high frequent diseases included in the general medicine specialty. And if you take the procedures, we can see these higher number of beneficiaries come under higher dialysis cases. So we can see this higher number of patients who are suffering from dialysis have been benefited from the benefited from the scheme. And there is also higher dialysis, and also there is also general medicine. Also, people benefited in the general medicine specialty. Most of the beneficiaries and most of the hospital services provided in the PMJAY scheme, including general medicine or general medicine specialty, and most of the beneficiaries who got benefited when it comes to procedures, out of these 1573 procedures, most of the beneficiaries got registered under dialysis services. And there is also V-shaped recovery, thanks to V-shaped recovery of care seeking. This V-shaped recovery we also studied in the very first chapter of this economic survey. This V-shaped recovery is still clearly evident in the healthcare services provision as well, even thanks to COVID-19 pandemic. The V-shaped recovery in the provision of healthcare services in PMJAY can be observed. So the recovery, that the number of cases in specialties and procedures is steeply declined due to COVID-19 and suddenly inclined, and this is a V-shape recovery. We can observe pre-COVID-19 and after COVID-19. So with this V-shape recovery, we can assume that the scheme has been very effective in providing healthcare insurance and healthcare services to the poor people from rural areas and vulnerable sections. There is also with this data, we try to analyze the effectiveness of JHO's PMJAY scheme by comparing various healthcare outcomes in based on the National Family Health Survey 4, which was conducted in 2015, and National Family Health Survey 5, which was conducted in 2019. So this scheme has been implemented in 2018. So it is better to compare the impact of the scheme by taking the data from National Family Healthcare Survey 4, which was conducted in 2015, and after 3 years, this scheme has been introduced. And we also compare this effectiveness of this scheme. Immediately after this introduction, we also conducted National Family Healthcare Survey 2019. So we will take the baseline data of NFS National Family Health Survey 4, and we'll try to compare the effectiveness of the scheme based on various health outcomes. For this we are using difference and indifference analysis. Before doing that difference and indifference analysis, we also try to compare the distribution of expenditure in the PMJAY scheme. If you compare the distribution of long tailed one that peaks in the range of most of the health distribution, most of the amount, most of the cost that spend on the diseases are in the range of 10,000 to 15. So we can see this long tail which expands to the general medicine. And the higher expense has taken the right tail, higher expense, lower high expense, lower low. We can see this lower high and high expenses. The lower tiles is the right end tile, shows the lower cases of labor, number of pre-authorizations. We are comparing the graph using taking pre-authorizations in the y-axis and average cost on the x-axis. And if you plot the graph, so this is the 5 lakh pre-authorizations, 10 lakh pre-authorization, 15 lakh pre-authorization, and 20 lakh pre-authorization, and cost we have included from 10,000 to 1 lakh. So if you compare the cost distribution, expenditure distribution, most of the beneficiaries are the most of the cost in the range of 10,000 to 15,000, which included in the general medicine category, general medicine specialty. But the higher cost for the diseases or the procedures which needs higher cost, actually lower number of cases have been registered in the time period, in the same time period, which requires higher cost. That's why we can see this lower right tile in the graph. We can see that. So before, after this, we discuss the difference indifference analysis based on the National Family Health Survey 4 and National Family Health Survey 5 by taking the data from these two surveys, and also we try to compare the health outcomes in West Bengal and also the contiguous states around West Bengal, the states surrounding West Bengals. The states surrounding West Bengals are Assam, Bihar and Sikkim, which implemented this PM Jan Arogya Yojana scheme, and West Bengal which has not implemented, which is not part of this PMJAY scheme. We try to compare the health outcomes based on the two surveys. In these two, actually this difference and indifference analysis, the survey conducted in two parts. First part about comparing these health outcomes between West Bengal and the states surrounding West Bengal. Why West Bengal we are trying to compare here, the survey trying to compare is because West Bengal did not implement the PMJAY scheme, whereas the Assam, Sikkim and Bihar, they implemented this scheme. And we also try to do this difference and indifference analysis in states which have not implemented PMJAY and also in states which implemented PMJAY scheme. So if you take this analysis, why we are comparing West Bengal and Assam, Bihar and Sikkim, all the states have almost similar socio-economic background and they are contiguous states and similar socio-economic background. So if you take this data, if you compare these outcomes, stretches from, first if you take the indicators, sex ratio improvement, the sex ratio in West Bengal improved by 1.35% in the period 2015 to 19 in the National Family Health Survey. The other states, the sex ratio, the other states like Assam, Sikkim and Bihar, this ratio has been improved to 6.28%. So there is a contraction, there is a huge difference in the sex ratio improvement in West Bengal, which has not implemented this scheme, and the states Assam, Bihar, Sikkim, which have implemented this scheme. The other indicator, enrollment in the level of schooling. So this difference and indifference analysis we are doing not only with the confounding factors, but also not only done to mitigate the confounding factors, we are also including secular impacts, secular improvements in the health indicators, secular improvements in the health indicators. That is why, apart from sex ratio, we are also trying to compare the other indicators, like other secular indicator like school education, increase in the school enrollment level in the school. If you take the 10 years, women who completed 10 years of school, the data shows that all the four states have improved the women who have completed 10 years of school. But West Bengal has done better here, 24%, and the other states almost done 20%. But health insurance coverage, if you take health insurance coverage, which is a very important and prominent indicator to compare this data in health outcomes, if you take health indicators, West Bengal, the other three states, Assam, Bihar and Sikkim, it is coverage of health indicator, health insurance increased by 89%, whereas in West Bengal, it is increased only by 12%. There is a huge gap between West Bengal, which has not been implementing this scheme, and the other states which have been implementing this scheme. So in the others, Assam, Sikkim and Bihar, the health insurance coverage improved by 89%, but in these states, it improved only by 12%. Similarly, the other indicators, infant and child mortality, if you compare this data in West Bengal and Assam, in West Bengal, the infant mortality rate has been decreased by only 20%, whereas in other states, it is decreased by 28%. The infant mortality rate in West Bengal decreased by only 20%. The other three states, it is decreased by 28%. Similarly, if you take the child mortality rate or under 5 mortality rate, the the under 5 mortality rate in West Bengal decreased by again 20%, but these data shows that it has been decreased by 27% in other three states. So the decline, the gap in the performance between West Bengal and other three states on the health indicators, this shows that the scheme, the outcome of health indicators have been more effective in the states where the PMJAY scheme has been implemented. This includes family planning, maternal and child health, regulated registered pregnancies. If we take the registered pregnancies, which is an important data, registered pregnancies in West Bengal increased only by 1%, whereas in the other states increased by 3%. In all indicators, there is a gap. There is a gap between the states which have been implementing this scheme and also the states which have not been implementing this scheme. Now compare these. We will do this difference analysis by comparing the states which are not implementing this PMJAY scheme and the states which are implementing this PMJAY scheme. In this also there is a huge gap between the health indicators. If you take the, first of all, let's take the health insurance coverage indicator, because it is the most important indicator when you compare the effectiveness of this scheme. So in this also, the health insurance coverage in the states improved by 54% in the states which are implementing this PMJAY scheme. The health insurance coverage improved by 54%, but whereas in the states which have not included, which are not implementing this scheme, the health insurance coverage interestingly has been fallen by 10% reduction. There is a reduction in the health insurance coverage by 10%, which is not a good indicator to meet the welfare needs of the vulnerable sections. Similarly, level of schooling also, women with more than 10 years schooling is also performed well in the states. This indicator also performed well in the states which implemented this PMJAY scheme, and this is not performing well in the states which are not implementing this PMJAY scheme. Similarly, infant and child mortality rate has decreased by 22% in the states which implementing this PMJAY scheme, but it only fallen by 16% in the states which are not implementing this PMJAY scheme. Similarly, the other indicators, if you take the family planning has been increased by 15% in the states implementing PMJAY, and the states which are not implementing the family planning increased only by 7%. Not only these indicators, if you take maternal health and child health, institutional birth and vaccination of the children and provision of vitamin A indicators, supplementation, child diseases reduction, and one more indicator, important indicators, that awareness about HIV and AIDS in the states. Interestingly, in the states which are implementing this PMJAY scheme, there has been improvement in the persons who have a fair knowledge about HIV and AIDS. If you take these data in the states which are implementing this PMJAY, there is a significant increase in the percentage of women who have comprehensive knowledge about HIV and AIDS. There is a 13% of increase in the women in the states which implementing PMJAY scheme and who have the comprehensive knowledge about HIV and AIDS. But whereas in the other states which are not implementing PMJAY, the increase in the percentage is only 2%. Only 2% increase in the women who have fair knowledge about HIV and AIDS. So overall, PMJAY scheme has been very effective scheme for meeting the welfare needs of the poor people. So if you see this data from difference and indifference analysis, most of the improvement not only pertaining to the health indicators, the scheme resulted in other spillover effects too. For example, if you take the HIV and AIDS awareness or the improvement in the school levels or the family health or number of institutional deliveries, this is all the spillover effects produced by the implementation of PMJAY scheme. So right now, so this is the time we should adopt this scheme to save the poor and vulnerable sections from the health crisis, and by providing a constant and protected health insurance scheme which has a profoundal benefits not only in health health indicators and also the secular indicators which are the product of spillover effect of the PMJAY scheme. Thank you very much.